Welcome back to the Buzzbeer Podcast. It's your boy Connor.
I'm Darius.
I'm Carson.
Today we're going to be doing our own NBA mock draft full first round. Anything else you guys have to add?
Nope. Let's get into it,
man. My first pick, Detroit Pistons.
Cade Cunningham.
Luka Garza. Nah, I'm kidding. Whoa. Obviously, Cade Cunningham. There should be no debate in that. Second pick for the Rockets. This is kind of an easy one. No, I'm going to go De'Ron Sharpe out of North Carolina.
What?
No, I'm
sure.
I'm messing with Carson.
Hey, as a Rockets fan, yeah, it's basically already locked up that we're taking Jalen Green. If we don't get the number one pick by trading with Detroit, it's basically a lock. We're taking Jalen Green. So
Jalen Green, welcome.
Jalen Green, yes.
Okay, Cleveland. I don't have them taking Evan Mobley like a lot of people do. No. They have a lot of very good big
men. Their bigs are like, they're big on the stack.
They have a stacked big man.
You can see right here, it's high.
Yeah, no, but you want, no, I'm thinking, so they have, bam, Darius Garland. They keep Colin Sexton. Kevin Love, Jared Allen. Yeah. Who do they all have? A small forward. That's where Jonathan Kuminga comes in.
Okay.
I have Kuminga going number
Kuminga
three.
Kuminga going in the top three. That is...
Because he just fits better, in my opinion, though.
Yeah.
He fits better. Obviously, Cavs can make some trades, you know?
Listen.
I don't know.
What happened? This is the example I use every time. What happened with the Warriors? They needed a center, right? They go out and get James Wiseman. They could have taken LaMelo. You have to go talent over fit any day.
I don't think...
That's why Evan Mobley, if you can slide him at the four, and then... Because let's be honest here, Kevin Love, he's done. Let's be honest, he's probably not going to
there's
going to
be trades that both happen, so, like...
I'm taking Evan Mobley with the third pick. If you pass up on a generational talent,
yeah, that's another thing.
That,
you can't pass up just before he fits better, but I actually... You changed my mind, I agree. Evan Mobley?
Evan Mobley.
Okay, with the Raptors...
Suggs, there's no...
Suggs. Jalen Suggs.
They compare Van Fleet and Suggs.
That could be...
Kyle Lowry's probably
going to
leave
off the bench or something.
Free agency.
Magic, I haven't taken Jonathan Kuminga.
Power forward. They have already a high power forward.
It's
no, but he plays both small.
It's either between Jonathan Kuminga or Scottie Barnes.
Jonathan Kuminga definitely has the better potential. Yeah, he's definitely the better one. And he needs to turn that Magic franchise around, if we're being honest. Okay, Oklahoma City Thunder. What's 17 picks in this year's draft, dude? Like,
they're going to be drafting Connor in 2035,
dude, yeah.
So let's keep an eye out for that.
What's their need? It says their need is small forward and center.
I can see
that. So
they need a big.
Definitely giving away Moses Moody in the Celtics trade.
He's Moses Brown.
Moses Brown.
After giving away Moses Brown and Al Horford, they need a center. It doesn't really look like this.
So,
but they have so many picks, you got to think. Like, as of right now.
They could get Chet Holmgren next year.
They could. That'd be a good big one.
That'd be crazy.
But I think Scottie Barnes fits well with
them. I think Scottie is
a tall small forward for them.
Small forward position.
And that's a super young team. So
you could also say Davion Mitchell and Shea as a good point guard, shooting guard duo, but it really depends.
Yeah.
Really depends.
Okay, the Golden State Warriors. It's a playoff team with two lottery picks. Like,
it's wild.
This doesn't happen often either. Like, MVP candidate, then gets a lottery pick. I don't have them taking Davion.
Really? I think he's going to the Warriors.
I think their point guard needs right now, they have... I mean, Curry, obvious. And off the bench, you guys forget, they have Jordan Poole off the bench. Super young guard.
Yeah.
He really has... I can see him averaging 15 points next year off the bench.
Yeah.
I can see him being a great six man. So, yes, Davion will be the clear talent fit, but...
I think, again, like what they're doing, they're building that team young, so they got to go with a position this time. And there's still positions, so I think they have to go with a small forward, a bench under Andrew Wiggins. What do you guys have, though? It's either Jalen Johnson or Franz Wagner.
Franz Wagner.
He's nice.
I think I'm going to go Jalen Johnson because I feel like he fits more. Yes, they're shooting. They don't need shooting, though.
And was that Jalen Johnson where his vertical is insane? Like, or was that Keon Johnson?
That was Keon Johnson, I'm pretty sure. Jalen Johnson still can get up there and stuff, but he's more of a driving paint. You know? And they don't need really any more shooting with Klay and Curry.
Yeah,
so
they're one of the best
shooting
teams.
They're going to take Jalen Johnson. Fits better with the team.
Dang. High pick for Jalen Johnson. Magic. Okay. Magic with the eighth pick.
The Magic, we already got them taking Jonathan Kuminga. So, who do they take next?
I think this is a no-brainer, honestly, in my opinion. I think Davion Mitchell.
Markelle and Cole Anthony?
Markelle Fultz, let's be honest here, he's probably not going to stay healthy. And Davion can play the two. Yes, he'd be undersized, but he can play the two.
No, but if I'm going to play with the two, I'm taking Keon Johnson and James Bocknight. They're both 6'5 shooting guards.
Okay.
Keon Johnson, I feel like, would fit perfect. With his athletic, Jonathan Kuminga and Keon Johnson coming into your lineup, I would not be disappointed.
You can't pass up on talent, though, Reggie. I think you have to go.
I think you got to go Davion Mitchell.
But you already have so much talent at that
position. Okay, are you taking Fultz or Davion Mitchell, though?
Yeah, but there's so many better. I think Keon Johnson fits better and can possibly be better. Like, Davion Mitchell, he's not going to be starting immediately. And I feel like he can do that for another team.
Nah.
He's going to get playing time one way or another.
Listen, this is our mock draft, so we could be taking these players. But in real life, the Magic are not passing up on Davion Mitchell. They're taking him no matter what.
Okay, Kings. Sacramento Kings. I don't know. Point guard they don't need.
No, they got De'Aaron Fox.
It all depends. Harrison Barnes they're going to keep. What happens with Marvin Bagley? It's on my side.
I think he's going to get traded this offseason.
I think they need an athletic shooting guard. They need like a guy that can score the ball, dribble the ball.
They also have...
But Buddy's a shooting guard. I think he's I think Buddy Mill or a shooting, like he's just a shoot type of guy. He's a perfect six man, in my opinion. He's a really good six man, Buddy Hield.
Yeah.
So I think James Bouknight, because he can handle the ball pretty well and can get a bucket whenever he wants. Cool. So,
true.
James Bouknight.
Cool. Squad. Good for him.
Pelicans.
All right. I have an opinion on this one. Pelicans with the 10th pick, right? Mm-hmm. This is the 10th pick. Mm-hmm. I have them taking Corey Kispert out of Gonzaga.
Small forward?
Yep.
Really?
Why?
I know they have Brandon Ingram. Listen, I know they have Brandon Ingram. But what is the main problem with that team? And the reason why Zion wants to leave. They have no shooters.
No,
no shooters to surround Zion. They need to take a shooter. They need to take the best shooter in the draft in Corey Kispert.
Oh, the best they have at least right now.
Yeah. But, I think they just need to take a guy that can surround Zion. Because when Zion's driving, he needs to kick out someone who can make a shot. And I think Corey Kispert will really thrive in the NBA. So that's why I have them going with an early... kind of shocking pick and taking Corey Kispert.
I could see that.
Franks Wagner or Corey Kispert, because those guys are both shooters and they both have height on them.
Or a center. I don't know what centers are available right now, but
there's not really a lot of good centers in this draft outside of Evan Mobley.
Yeah, centers this year not that great because
maybe you can get one steal in the second round, but
yeah,
I don't see anything over two, maybe even three first round centers.
Yeah, they're just center's not that great this year.
And the only reason there would be a center, it wouldn't probably because of talent, is because they needed one. Like, they needed one type of situation. But yes, Frank Wagner, Corey Kispert, what do you guys want?
Kispert. I mean, I think Kispert's gotta go better, Kispert. So I gotta think go Kispert. It's a high pick, but I think Corey Kispert.
Okay. Moving on to the Hornets. Beast team.
They could use another point they guard need to back up LaMelo.
I know, they need a big man.
They got Devontae Graham. They need a big man. Their starting big man is...
Cody Zeller.
Listen, he's not bad.
That's where I have...
It just needs something.
Top power forwards are what? Yusman Garba?
You got to go a big, I think. You have to go an official
or
big.
Or Kai Jones. I've heard high thing from this Kai Jones. I don't think... Do you think he goes this early, though?
You have to go a big here. Like, an actual center. Like, not a power forward.
That's the thing. There's no centers in this draft. Like,
I know, but...
They got, I'm going to butcher this name, but Alperen Sengun.
I'm going to be honest, I've never heard of him before.
He's a very small center, a 6'5", 6'9 center. So are you going to take a chance on that? He is ranked number 14. Are you going to take a chance on that?
It's either that, hope in free agency, or you get a bench. And I'm going back to what Darius said, he might have to get a backup. At least, I want someone with height. You know, at least someone with height.
They need another
look
guard.
At this small forward. They really do. Small forward, Franks Wagner, is the same height as a second best center in this draft.
Yeah.
Franks Wagner gives them height, and he's a solid player.
Yeah, definitely a solid player. I don't see him starting, but he would definitely
be a solid. And he can switch between small forward and power forward for them. 6'9 is a really good height for them. I haven't taken Franks Wagner.
Cool.
Yeah.
That's a good pick.
And now the San Antonio Spurs.
This is a weird team.
It's a 100% weird team.
I think DeJounte Murray, I think he's leaving. I think he's going to get traded. There's been a lot of rumors about it.
Oh.
So, okay. A point guard maybe?
A point guard?
I have them taking Keon Johnson. It's a shock that he's still here, to be honest. If he falls all the way to the Spurs, I think it's a no-brainer to take Keon Johnson.
He's a super athletic guy. DeMar DeRozan could be out of there. I feel like he can be really good too, Keon Johnson.
Yeah.
Next up we have... the Indiana Pacers. This team, in my opinion, has the most overall team that, like, it doesn't have any superstars. It has maybe a couple people that could
be
the most
average team.
They're just an average team. They have a.
I think Brogdon's going to get moved this offseason. I really do.
Really?
I've heard.
They might deal him out to a team, maybe like the Knicks. I can maybe see Brogdon getting traded out to the Knicks. I could see him going to a team. I know the Heat, you know, but I can see him maybe getting moved to the Heat for, like, Tyler Hero. and Duncan Robinson, a bunch of those guys. Yeah, so you know. I honestly have them taking a shooting guard because Caris LeVert, he might not stay healthy. You know, you got to think about him too because he didn't really play that amazing last year. Yeah. I know he went through all like the like just health problems in general, or the injuries, was the health.
Yeah.
So I think they should just take the best guy available and hope for the best.
Yeah. But like at shooting guard, no. Yeah, you're right.
I think you should take the best guy available.
Yeah,
I think
for them, Josh Giddey, 6'8" from Australia.
Josh Giddey.
Okay, next up, but the Golden State Warriors again.
Warriors again.
This is where now you go for the position.
Okay, this is where you go for the position.
This is where you go for the position. Small forward or shooting guard. Which one you guys want?
Let's look at some small forwards.
Small forwards, the next ranked is 45.
Okay.
Go to shooting guard.
Shooting guards,
yeah.
Moses Moody can get a bucket.
Oh, Moses Moody. Can't pass on that. Shockey's honestly ranked this
Trey low. Murphy's in there too.
And we're using a website where it shows all the projected players and like where they're projected to. We're just putting it together where they think they're going to get picked.
And next up, we have the Wizards.
Washington? You got to go shooting guard. Beal is going to be gone next year.
Oh,
so,
that's a claim.
That's debatable type of thing.
Let's just say, you know, I guess most of our picks we based on is who's leaving, like the Spurs and Brogdon and all those guys. So, but
I don't. Bradley Beal says he wants to stay, so I don't know.
Yeah, but
yeah,
I don't know.
I think at this point you need a bench because you can't, like, the centers aren't that good, you know.
Yeah,
but also their backup centers are garbage, so.
You
Let's
got
be honest
Thomas
here.
Bryant. I think
this guy obviously
he's ranked 14th for a reason.
I've
never watched him, so no disrespect to him whatsoever.
He's 6'9", so obviously I can see him being like a Ben Wallace player or like a Montrezl Harrell type of player where he's just an athletic center that can I can just get it done honestly and
so,
score.
Yeah,
quickly.
I'll
take him.
No film on him whatsoever, but hopefully the Wizards do film on him. Okay, next up we have Oklahoma's second out of the 17 picks, dude.
They got a lot of picks this year.
They do have a lot of picks. This is, again, a young team. What do you think they do with this? So we have them taking Scotty Barnes with a 6th pick, and
I
got them a small forward.
I think you go talent over need.
I think talent over
Sharif Cooper would be nice.
Sharif Cooper, point guard.
Trey Murphy, too.
I like Sharif Cooper.
I do, too.
Sharif Cooper.
He's nice.
Yeah, Sharif Cooper. I really like that.
All right. Sharif Cooper for the Thunder. Thunder.
Okay.
Grizzlies.
The Grizzlies.
Oof. Okay.
The Grizzlies, I feel like they could use a backup, a really good six man.
I don't think this is even a debate. They need to go talent here.
Usman. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think there's no debate on that one.
Next up, we got the Thunder again.
The Thunder. Okay. Wow. No, who would have thought? It's Thunder. I have so many picks.
You know what? Okay, this is what I'm doing. So they need a center. It says it's a severe on center.
Yeah, they don't.
Ty Jones is ranked as a power forward, right?
Mm-hmm.
There's so many good big men that have come out of Texas. That's what you got a basis off to.
True.
Like, you got to think Kevin Durant, Jared Allen. Miles Turner. Those are just guys that come to my head immediately. I'm pretty sure there's another big one. Maybe LaMarcus Aldridge, if I'm not mistaken.
And I think, was AD, didn't he come out?
No, he came Kentucky.
Kentucky, that's what
no, I could be wrong about LaMarcus Aldridge, but there's been a lot of really good big men coming out of Texas lately.
Yeah.
At this point, it's not like they need one type of thing. And I have them taking Ky Jones from Texas.
Ky Jones. That's a good pick.
I like that.
That's a good pick.
Now you got the New York Knicks, the playoff hopefuls.
19th pick.
Yeah.
I think
Trey Murphy.
Yeah.
They need a scorer. And he's a 6'8 scorer.
Needs a scorer. Yeah. They honestly have great scorers in their lineup already. Quickly, Randall, Derrick Rose, honestly, he can still get it done. If they can add one more scorer to their, you know,
they need
team,
someone to like, yes, Julius Randle was off.
Yeah,
and he was off that playoffs. If they can rely on someone like, because no disrespect to Derrick Rose, he's not it anymore. You can't rely on him scoring. You can't rely on him scoring at least.
They're relying on him to be the third, fourth option on that team, which scoring-wise, he can't do. Passing-wise, you know, distributing the ball, he can still do.
He's a perfect starting point guard for you. You want that on your team. They need that second scorer that can score because RJ Barrett's not there yet. A whole bunch of guys aren't there. Like, they're not there yet. A young guy's.
A young scorer that can develop with the whole team.
Yeah,
that would just make
6'8" shooting guard. Trey Murphy. Perfect. Now we have the Atlanta Hawks.
20th pick. Wow. Let's talk about the Hawks, man. They surprised everyone. Almost beat the Bucks.
Every single year, there's a team that surprised us.
Yeah.
Miami Heat last year. It was the Hawks this year.
Yeah.
So that means they're one step closer in this young franchise team.
I really don't think the draft is going to matter to them this much this year. Like, cool, we got a lottery pick. Let's
or not
take,
a lottery pick, but like, or sorry, first round pick.
First round pick.
Yeah.
Let's take the best guy available and see if
it says
develops.
Right here,
they need
almost
they need
all
nothing.
Of them is average. Yeah. So they have a really good overall average team. You go with talent here. Trinan. Best talent on the board is
Isaiah Jackson.
Yeah.
Power forward out of Kentucky.
Like that's a big power forward. Almost 7 foot. Can
big,
throw it in the paint. He looks like a big guy.
Big guy.
Next, you got the Knicks again.
We took a guard last time, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Trey Murphy.
Go Ooh. Forward.
Who's that down there? Zaire Williams?
Zaire Williams, 6'8 out of Stanford.
6'8 shooting guard? Listen, I know he just took a shooting guard.
But I don't... Jared
That's
Butler,
an NBA small
Jared
forward.
Jared Butler from Baylor. Think of the stats he put up with Xavier Mitchell. Like...
Yeah.
They
I
have
think
a
that's,
nice rookie point guard
bam,
shooting guard.
You have... Look at
bench.
This, look at
that's...
this. So, for the Knicks, you got Derrick Rose, Jared Butler. Amanda Quickley, Trey Murphy. And then you have the rest of the line of Mitchell Robinson, Julius Randle, RJ Barrett, like...
Their
you're,
guards would be insane.
You're solidifying the bench, getting the bench insane. Younger, getting the team younger. And plus, if you're behind even both of rookies, if you're behind Derrick Rose teaching
yeah.
you, MVP.
That would be
He was an MVP at their age, and they're just getting drafted. Like, that is a really good pick. I have Jared Butler from Baylor.
Cool. That's a good pick.
That, it really goes... Uh-oh. We got the Los Angeles Lakers.
The Los Angeles Lakers. Shout out Space Jam. We just saw the movie last night.
Yeah.
It was great.
Good.
It was good.
You can go guard. They need a guard. They really
do. Oh, yeah.
Trey Man
6'5"?
Yep.
Schroeder's probably gone.
Schroeder's gone.
He's acting for too much money. Just.
Oh, yeah. His
they
his
need
money
to make
is
a whole bunch of roster moves.
Yeah.
To be fair. So, yeah Trey Man, that's a solid pick.
Right they there. Need a guard really bad.
Like, if you
have
the Rockets again.
The
Rockets. All right. Come from the Rockets fans. The guards that we were hoping to draft are off the board. Trey Man, Jared Butler, all those guys. They're off the board. We are taking center.
Jaron Sharp. That's a really good pick.
Jaron Sharp.
I really like that pick.
We need a center. We need a backup center. There's no doubt about that.
He's not obviously a tall center. He's 6'11". Obviously, that's tall. But looking at the centers nowadays, he's a big body center. He's like a Zion.
He's athletic. He can get it done in the paint. Sure, his shooting, you know, whatever. Might not be the best. But when you surround him with guys who can shoot, he'll be a good player. And then, so Jaron Sharp with the 23rd pick. And then, honestly, this next pick.
Don't do Chris Derrick. I think you choose 6'8 Zaire Williams for height because you put him in small forward, too.
That is a good pick.
Yeah.
Yeah, all the guards are gone that we wanted to take.
Zaire Williams. Because you can switch him at any position because of his height. Yep. There's a lot of tall guys that at their height.
Mm-hmm.
Next up, we have the Clippers. The Clippers are in need of...
Point guard, that's for sure.
Point guard.
I need a guard.
Like, a guard. Yeah, like, a guard. So, someone that can, like, facilitate the ball... Type of that, like, there's a chance Reggie Jackson stays, there's a chance he doesn't. This team's only getting older type of thing. I have them, since I'm the Clippers fan, I haven't taken Cameron Thomas.
Cameron Thomas
shooting guard? He's 6'4", he's a shooting guard, but he can play point guard type of thing. All right. I haven't taken that, so yeah. Welcome to
team. Let's just hope all the guys that we're taking are now saying, oh, they can switch out positions.
They do.
I mean, that should be, honestly, a requirement
be,
in the NBA to be a multiple position guard or big. So
because you're not going to make it far if you're just one position.
Yeah.
There's too many good players in the NBA now.
Because look at players like Giannis. Look at players like Tatum.
Yeah.
They can play 1-5.
LeBron,
all those guys. They can play 1-5 and get it done. That's what makes players superstars now is if you can play multiple positions. Yeah.
True.
Here comes the Nuggets. I think this is a no-brainer. Best on the board, Chris Durant out of Oregon. Averaged 20 points this year. Like, that, you know, that's really good for a college level.
You average 20 in college.
And they
pretty,
need that
good.
Type of score, especially with Jamal Murray gone. And he can do everything.
I think
that's
he's
the 6'6".
Perfect pick.
That's a really good pick, Chris Durant. I hopefully didn't put your name in. Huge Oregon fan, though. Next, we've got the Brooklyn Nets. How are they going to build this team even more?
What do they need?
Center.
Power forward.
They need a center.
Blake Griffin's probably gone.
They need a center.
I can see them taking
They need a center really bad.
Definitely a center.
Luka Garza.
Or
not in the first round. He is not going in the first round.
Or a really lengthy small forward power forward.
Power forward.
I can see them.
JT Thor, 6'10".
Check small forwards.
There's
curious. There's no more 45, small forwards.
Yeah. I think JT Thor's
I think JT Thor's
He looks like a Zion type of dude. So, we have JT Thor going to the Nets. That's one of those sleeper picks, too, like, protected go second round, Bam takes in the first round type of thing.
Yeah.
Next, we have the 76ers.
I mean...
What did they... Like, what's happening with Ben Simmons and stuff? Yeah.
I think they just flat out need a point guard that can score the ball.
Jaden Spring. Right there.
He's a great player.
They need a point guard. Like, sadly, Ben Simmons, they need someone that can do everything. Yeah. And Ben Simmons can shoot, so Jaden Springer, there you go. Now we have the Suns, the finals team.
They're the most balanced team.
I really don't even think they need anything. Best on the board.
They could use a backup point guard.
You know, yeah, that's what I was going to say. I was going to say they could use a point guard that can, whatchamacallit, learn from Chris Paul.
Yeah.
Because if that sets you up for the future, like.
Because they have now, you know, Chris Paul, Devin Booker, and
Cameron Payne.
Mikal Bridges and Cameron Payne.
Yeah.
Those are great guards. If they can get add one more guard to that piece, that'd be
and
pretty
that's
good.
Where this comes in. Miles McBride, I've watched some of his games from March Madness. He's actually very good controlling the game. He controls the game. He's like, I'm not going to compare him to Luka, but you know how Luka's very slow with the ball and stuff like that?
He definitely speeds up or slows down the pace of the game. Yeah, that's a very important skill in the NBA.
And Miles McBride, I think, gives that to him. That's someone to give behind.
Yeah,
I like that.
And then the best pick in the league, the Jazz, get the last pick in this year's draft.
I mean, talent.
Honestly, talent.
Just talent. They need a power forward.
It looks like they need a power forward.
Power forward, pretty high on.
Or maybe a lengthy small forward.
Lengthy small forward. I don't see any good power forwards as of right here.
Look for a lengthy small forward.
Isaiah
Todd is a beast, but he's a second round pick.
Yeah. If you're trying to do this again,
I think you just go talent, to be honest. Like talent.
Yeah. Josh Christopher, second highest vertical.
Or
Josh from Alabama. He was their only type of guy on that team.
Yeah.
He has a team. Talent, and hopefully you get your needs. Since
I don't know,
there's a really good chance you don't get with the 30th pick. You don't get your position in the draft.
Yeah,
that's where you're gonna hope with free agency. Yeah, if you really want a center so bad, that's where you go in free agency because you don't test your luck with the 30th pick in the draft.
Yeah,
so that's where you go. Best on the board.
Take talent. Primo.
And that is our full on first round mock draft.
That is our mock draft.
If you guys want us to do a second round, put in the comments. We will 100% do.
There's a lot of talent coming out of the second round this year. So
this is a really good draft.
If you guys want to see the second round. Let us know down in the comments.
I think it's pretty good for the building.
It's way too dumb, yeah.
We'll see you guys next time.
I get those goosebumps every time. I need the Heimlich. Throw that to the side, yo. I get those goosebumps every time.